Yeah. So do you remember yesterday we learned about the earth, its shape, globe? Actually, the name of the lesson is globe, what we have last week studied, right? The globe, what is a globe? Globe is a model of the earth. And what does it show? How does it help us? It helps us to see the land, ocean, continents, countries. Isn't it? The imaginary line on the globe. And what are these imaginary lines called? So first type of imaginary attitudes. What are the two different types of imaginary lines we have, children? We have two imaginary lines, two different types of imaginary lines, that is latitudes and longitudes. Children, so you have to I'll be displaying the picture on the video on your screen. If you can see, last week we have learned already about the latitude, right? Now we are going to learn about the longitudes. Longitudes are the lines which are drawn vertically, which are drawn vertically from North Pole to South Pole. If you observe the diagram, if you observe the longitudes diagram, it is the South Pole, North Pole, and this is the South Pole, children. How many poles we have? South and North, isn't it? The axis on which the Earth rotates or the globe rotates, that is called an axis. And it passes through the Earth, which is not actually there on the Earth, but it is an imaginary line again. Shows about, which indicates the North Pole and the South Pole, children. Yeah. So the 0 degree longitude is called a prime meridian, right, children? 0 degree longitude is called a prime meridian, which is dividing the Earth in two equal halves. Right, children? From 0 degree prime meridian to the east, it is called Eastern Hemisphere. Similarly, from 0 degree to south, towards the south, it is called Southern Hemisphere. So, children, we are going to learn the what are the characteristics of these lines. Right, children? So as we have learned about the latitudes, right, there are 181 degrees of latitudes, isn't it, children? So we have total 360 degrees of longitudes. How many? 360 degrees of longitudes. 180 is towards the west, the other 180 is towards the east. Okay, 0 degree is a prime meridian, which is dividing the Earth into two equal hemispheres, that is Western Hemisphere and the Eastern Hemisphere. You know the directions, yeah, children? Top is North, bottom is South, and this is Western, and this is Eastern side, right? From 0 degree prime meridian to the East, you have 180 degree longitudes. Similarly, from 0 degree to the West, you have 180 degrees longitudes. Isn't it, children? So that makes 180 plus 180 makes 360 degrees of longitude. And this 0 degree prime meridian passes through the bridge, which is in London. Greenwich is a place situated in London. So this line of 0 degree prime meridian passes through the Greenwich Greenwich in London. That is why this 0 degree prime meridian is also called as Greenwich line. What it is also called as? Greenwich line. Okay, and it is measured as 0 degree. Like equator is measured at 0 degree. Similarly, the what we say longitudes are also measured in from 0 degree. Pando? Understood? So there are 181 degrees, 180 to the east and 180 to the west longitudes. Isn't it, children? So opposite to the prime meridian, you just look into your book, children. Opposite to prime meridian, there is 180 degrees of longitudes. What are there? There are 180 degrees of longitudes, which is called the international date line, which is called as international date line. Now, you must be thinking that when there are 181 degrees of latitude, why there is not 361 degrees of longitude? Student, 180 degree of longitude is common to east and west. It is common to east and west. Understood, children? East and west. That is why there are 360 degrees of latitude. Like, unlike the latitudes, we have learned that all the latitudes are not same length. They differ in length. But longitudes, they are of same size. They are of same size when it comes about the longitudes, they are of same size. See here, it's from 0 degree and it ends at, it starts from North Pole and it's end to South Pole. So all the longitudes, if you observe, they are of equal length. But if you see the latitudes along latitudes which is to other side of your page, those latitudes are not same in size. When it's moving towards the pole, the size of the latitude is decreasing or reducing, you can say. But have you seen here any did you notice any longitude which is smaller in size? No, all the longitudes are of same size. So, unlike latitudes, longitudes, all the longitudes are of equal in length. But the distance between each longitude differs. Like distance between each latitude we have discussed is the same. Okay. But here, this distance between the longitudes are not same from pole to pole. Towards the pole, the distance is less, and in another at the center, if you notice, if you observe, the distance is more. This is because of the curvature of the Earth. Earth is spherical in shape. That is why when you draw the lines on the poles, on the globe, the longitudes will differ in the distance. As you go to the polar, the distance will reduce with them. And at the center, at the middle, you can say at the equator, the distance will be more. So these are the longitudes. And these longitudes, if you see, they have given in your book also, you see 30 degrees, 90 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 120, 150 and 180. So opposite to the prime meridian, you will get 180 degrees of longitude, which is called the international date line. And why it is called international date line? Because when you come to 180 degree longitude, the day changes. The day changes. The date changes. That is why it is called international date line. And the important feature of this longitudes are, it helps us in measuring the time. It helps us in calculating time. Now, as I told you, these are measured in degrees. Here, if you see 0 degree prime meridian, here it is a midday. Midday, that means 12 o'clock in the afternoon, right? So this line shows midday because at this time of, at this line, the sun is overhead. At this time, the sun is overhead, and that is why it is called the prime meridian and noon time. Opposite to that, 180 degrees of longitude is midnight 12 o'clock. What it is? Midnight 10 o'clock. See, children, the frequency of the longitudes to measure the time is taken as 15 degrees. 0 degree, 15 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree, 45 degree, okay, 60 degree, likewise 75 degree. So that means 0 to 15 degree, when it goes, moves, Earth moves from 0 degree longitudes to 15 degree longitudes, that means the place it is covering 1 hour time. Okay, children. So when we move eastwards, we are going forward in time, and when we are coming to westward, we are moving backward in the time. So that is why the countries which fall in the western side, so have you understood? The countries which are towards the east of the prime meridian, they will be ahead of the western countries. The time, for example, see here, if it is a, I said, I said 0 degree prime meridian shows 12th noon. What does it shows? The 1 o'clock. Showing 1 o'clock. But you will come towards the west to the 15 degree west. 15 degree east will show 1 o'clock after 12, 1 hour. Means from 0 to 1 degree longitude, if our time difference is 4. Okay. So 4 into 60 minutes. 0 to 1 degree longitude is a 4 minute time difference. So 4 minutes into 15 longitudes becomes 60 minutes. That means when you move from 0 degree prime meridian to 15 degree prime meridian, you have covered 1 hour. That means here, if it is 12 o'clock, then the places which lie on the 15 degree east will have 1 o'clock, afternoon 1 p.m. longitude will go backward. That means 12 o'clock noon is a 0 degree longitude, that is prime meridian. So minus 1, here you are going to subtract. So 12 minus 1, 11. So that means 15 degree west longitude, the places which falls on these longitudes will tell you the, they will have 11 a.m. So these are the important logs, and they are very, very important in finding out the local time as well as standard time, isn't it, children? So these are the important longitudes. Now I'll ask you a few questions, right, children? Which is the longest line of latitude? So equator is the longest line. Okay, now your, which is the like frozen latitude, children. So the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle are the frozen areas or cool areas, right, children? Now which line of longitudes, these longitudes are also called as meridians. All these longitudes are also called as meridians, okay, because they are telling us the time. So it is also called as meridians. Okay, children. So now tell me which line of longitude is called as 180 degree longitude. What is 180 degree longitude is called as, and what it is important? So degree longitude international date means which, where we, the date changes, the day goes ahead or it comes one day back. So here date changes, right, children? And what is the 0 degree longitude is called? It is called prime meridian. So these are the different types of longitudes and latitudes, what you have done till now. And it's very, very important. These lines are not actually existing on the Earth. It is the map makers who have made these lines. That is why these lines are called imaginary lines, which help us to locate the places at right place. Okay. Show the places at right, their actual place where they are situated in the world. Right, children? That is the importance of the line. Now, moving forward, grid. G-R-I-D. You have already learned this in last year also. Now, what is a grid, children? Can anybody will know? Anybody will tell me? Grid is nothing but it is the network of longitudes and latitudes. When longitudes and latitudes cross each other, they form a net. They form a net. And this helps us to find the correct location of the called a grid. What it is called? Grid. R-I-D. We have learned last year. Now, with this, we have completed this lesson. I hope you all have learned it, understood it. If you have not understood also, let us we'll send you the task sheet, which will help you to understand. And we're moving back to the first lesson. I was told that in that symbol portion is not completed. So let us move on to the previous lesson, symbols, children, which is the one of the important element of making maps, isn't it, children? Now suppose you want to show a Siddhartha school in a map. Now how will you show the Siddhartha school in a map? Are you going to make a map as big as the Siddhartha school is? No, it's not possible. It is highly impossible. So we have to indicate some symbol. We have to take some image which indicates, or some symbol which will indicate the Siddhartha school, right? So as we can't draw the actual picture of the thing on a map, we use the symbols to show them or indicate them on the map. Okay, there are some of the conventional symbols in the our map makers or cartographer has made it for their convenient to show the things on the map, right, children? There are many conventional symbols: temple, post office, okay, railway track, Kachcha road, Pakka road. Okay, you already have learned last year in your book. You all have the book with you. You can go through the book. You can see the book. On page number 6, there are different kinds of symbol, if you see, children. Okay, so if you are going want to show the trees or a forest, you have to draw a tree. That indicates that it is a complete picture of a complete place where the forest is located. And if you want to show a Kachcha road, that means you have to just to draw a dash lines, two dash lines, which will help you to say that or indicate that it is a Kachcha map. Similarly, temple, just a small diagram of temple will help you to find out what are these pictures. So these symbol, conventional symbols, are very, very important in locating map. Being a social studies student, one of you must know about this special feature of the element of the map making. So map makers have made these symbols to make their work convenient, and also the reader, those who are reading the maps, to understand the map in a better manner. In a better manner. It is not that map maker only can make the map using this symbol. You can also, when you want to show something on the map, you can also create your own symbol. You can indicate it as the index that this symbol indicates this particular item or a feature. So that is how the symbols help us in showing the things. Even the physical features also can be shown with the help of the symbols as well as color. Like you want to show a mountain, so you have to draw a small triangle and color it with a brown color. That indicates that it is a, what it is, it is a hill or a, it is a mountains. If you want to show the river, you have to show the river with line but with blue color, curved line with blue color, which indicates that the river is flowing, that is a river, and all the ocean bodies you will be covering with blue color. So that is how the things are, the features or the different places, actual places which we cannot show, so that can be shown with the help of the symbols. So these are the symbols which we have to, which is the part of the first lesson, which was not covered in your previous class. So I was informed to do that. So with this, the first lesson is also completed. So the children, I hope you all have understood the lesson. Now, let us have a recapitulation of the second lesson. So children, how many continent we have learned about in our previous second lesson, that globe, the shape of Earth or the model of the Earth? 7 continents. And how many oceans we have learned? 4 oceans. So what are those? Arctic Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean. So which is the largest ocean? Yeah, the largest ocean is Pacific Ocean. And which is the frozen ocean? Arctic Ocean is frozen ocean. Which continent is called, which landmass is called, continent is called ice shield? Antarctica is called ice shield. Okay. And shield of ice, you can say. Ice, shield of ice. Now, my next question is, who proved that the Earth is spherical in shape? Ferdinand Magellan has proved that the Earth is spherical. What is the importance or what is the role of the axis? This is also an imaginary line, okay, which connects North Pole and South Pole and helps the globe to rotate in west to east direction. Now my next question is, why is it is called that the sun rises from the east? Why do we say that sun rises from the east? The reason is the rotation of the Earth. As we have seen that the Earth rotates from west to east, the Earth rotates from, let us see now. See, now we have learned that Earth rotates from, okay, west to east. So that means we have also learned 1 day ahead of the prime meridian. Yes, children? So when the places located at the east will get exposure of the Earth sun first, the later on it comes to the western part. That is why we say that the Earth is rises from the east because of the rotation. Okay, children? Okay. So how many types of imaginary lines do we have? Longitudes, latitudes and longitudes. So how many latitudes are there total? 181 degrees of latitudes. How many longitudes are there? 360 degrees of longitudes. So latitudes and longitudes both are measured in degrees. How many seven important latitudes? What are the 7 important latitudes on the globe? It is equator, 0 degree longitude, latitude, 23 degree and a half north is topic of Cancer. 66 and a half degree north is a Arctic Circle. 90 degree north pole is it's a north pole. Similarly, towards the south, 23 and a half degree south is called a Tropic of Capricorn. 66 and a half degree south is called a Antarctic Circle, and 90 degrees south is called a South. So these are the seven important latitudes which help us to find out the climate. Now, how many? Which is the 0 degree longitude? The prime meridian is the 0 degree longitude. And do you know, children, in which hemisphere India lies? In which hemisphere India lies? We have learned that there are, if we see the longitudes, it is dividing the earth into two equal hemispheres, that is northern hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. If we see the latitudes, the equator is the longest latitude, which is dividing the earth into two equal latitudes. Okay, so there are two equal hemisphere, which is eastern hemisphere and northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. So now you tell me, according to the hemisphere, in which hemisphere does India falls in? So India comes falls in northern as well as eastern hemisphere. Okay, children, so it comes under northern and eastern hemisphere. So your task is to find out from the what we say from the atlas, or if you have the books, I think all of you have the books, and first and second lessons are available with all of you, right? In your page number, improve your learning, if you will see, in your page number 13 of page, there are four hemispheres given. Okay, you just have to find out in which, from with the help of these four hemisphere picture, you find out in which hemisphere is the India falls. Okay, so I have told you already, it is northern eastern hemisphere. Analyze whether it is right or wrong. Why is it if northern east, according to the division of the longitudes and latitudes, it falls in north and east hemisphere. Understood, children? Okay, right. So with this, I will ask you another question. Which all continent the equator passes through? Which all continent does the equator passes through? Okay. It passes through South Africa, South America, Africa, Asia. Okay, children, these are the continent through which the equator, line of equator passes through. I hope you all have understood the lesson. Anyone who have not understood the lesson, please make a note of the point where you have not understood. And you already have the print of these lessons. Make a clear note. What is a globe? How many continents? What is the use of globe? What is the shape of the globe? Who had proved this shape of the earth? And how many continents, how many oceans are there? Okay, what are the four directions and what are the sub-directions? Okay, total how many directions are there? What are their sub-directions? And what are imaginary lines? What are